never give up. All right, sounds good. Yep.
You don't need to take anything else off?
I'll just take this for now. Give it a test run. Lovely. That's the first thing done. It's all my electronics in there. We'll head back, get the next bag. That was the test run. A bit awkward. I threw all my water in there too. She's damn heavy. How are you? Hey seals. Here comes the wave. Slippery in here. Stay. That was a bit exciting.
Is that it?
Beautiful, that is everything.
Oh.
Alright, cheers. Yep. See you then. Alright, g'day everyone. So, another episode. Just been dropped off by a boat. Rough as guts ride out here. The acoustics is echoing in here, I just noticed. Just negotiated my way in on a kayak. Big thank you to the guys at Trailblazers for helping to make this trip happen. If you're ever in Albany and you need fishing or camping gear, Trailblazers, hit them up. Anyway, they've been dropped off by a boat. I'm going to be here for 3 days. Last time I was here, I caught a kingy on fly, and that was the last time I ever saw the top half of my fly rod. So I'm gonna check my old cam and see if I left it there. It'd be nice. I brought all my fly gear just in case I find it and I can use it. Other than that, the plan is head up, head around the back of the islands, gonna set up tent and set up camp there, leave all my gear. Now I'm coming back down here and we're gonna go fish somewhere. It's too rough to fish the back today. Tomorrow we're gonna fish the back. Got a full day tomorrow to do exploring and find some good ledges, hopefully. Last time there wasn't enough time. So yeah, that's what this trip is all about. We're gonna do some more exploring and see what we can catch here, and just check this place out even more. It's an epic place. Absolutely love it. And there's seals down here just hanging out. I'm just gonna go run down quickly and grab my rod and bring it up a tiny bit in case a big wave decides to come and wash it all away, and that would really ruin the trip. And then we're gonna throw the backpack on and go set the tent up. Hey buddy. Hello. With just one eye. Hello. Surprisingly friendly. I'm a bit cautious. They do have a set of teeth on them. And there's a bull just there. This one's a female sea lion. That's a male. But they're pretty chill. There's this one. Hey buddy. I was not expecting that. Hey, don't bite me. That is really cool. I was not expecting them to be that friendly. So, they're sniffing me. I think it's the bull making that weird sound. Sounds more like a pup squeaking away. Anyway. We will leave them alone. You almost want to pat them, but I don't think it's a good idea, because if they want to bite you, it'd be like getting bitten by a pretty nasty dog with teeth that would probably give you an infection. So as cool as it is, have to be a bit careful to not get too close. All right, just get my rods. So I've just sort of wedged the kayak there and tied it off, and I've got the esky with some ice and stuff in it to keep fish cool. I'm gonna throw the backpack on, as I've probably said a dozen times already, and we're just taking camping gear and dropping it and coming back to fish. Oh, out of breath just saying that. All right, let's go. I kind of feel like I took the wrong way. I'm meant to be walking on rocks right now, but I still can't find them. This is not much fun. It's all part of it though. There should be some rocks not far up. And once I get to the clearing, happy days. Oh, far out. Here we go. I'm out. Oh. Oh, my backpack is caught on that. So there, let's pull this bloody branch off. Oh. All right, done. Maybe there. A few slight options around, nothing's incredible. Might just go here, yeah, I don't know. Need to make up my mind. I want to go fishing already. Let's just drop that for a sec. We'll have a quick look. Might just go here. I was going to go there. I think I'll go here. I think I can wedge it in here somehow. Yeah, I'll make that work. I might just get a few rocks around it quickly and we'll get it set up. Get a few things out of my bag too. Just gonna be use some rocks and tie it down scenario. All right, let's get this tent out. Now I feel the salt spray coming off the ocean. Gee, my gear cops it sometimes though. Just this environment, harsh as. All right. So I haven't used this tent for a while, because it's just a bit heavier than my one man, but because I don't have to walk far this time, can drop by a boat, quick little walk, I figured I'd bring a little bit more room. I figured I'd bring a little bit bigger tent so I have a little bit more room, just make things a bit nicer. This one weighs about 2 kilos. Still not massive, still pretty light. Marva tent's about 1.3 kilos. This one's got quite a new, unique design. It's more of a mountaineering tent, and I have done some pretty good hikes in it in Tassie. Kind of like the setup of this one. The poles slip on the inside. Alright, so the tent's up. We're just going to throw a few things in. That's all my sleeping stuff in there, pretty much, plus the change of clothes. That's my rope. That in there. There we go. Beautiful. They'll hold that there just nicely. That just there, just nicely. How's this for a spot to set up the tent? Freaking a little bit interesting. And then I just want to get a cam or something. Yeah, that's perfect. And get a good placement in there. I hope I brought a change of undies. I can't see one at the moment. Maybe I forgot to bring a change of undies and I got my only undies wet on the way here. Oh, off to a flying start. All right, let's get out of here. Let's go catch some fish. All right, tent is set. We're good to go. Bit tricky to find a flat spot, but it's sort of a little bit of a V. In there I'll probably nestle into. Head up the top, I can't sleep with my head downhill. I think that's pretty standard. And look at this for a place to be camping like. It's amazing. But let's go catch some fish, because we need dinner. And I came here to fish, so that's what we're gonna go do. I'm very keen to get a line in the water. And the target species is this. That fella right there. Kingy, yellowtail kingfish, yellowtail amberjack, whatever you want to call it, I call it Kingy for short. That's what we're going for. All right, let's go catch some fish. Got my fishing gear back in there. Leave some of this stuff here. And we might even grab a few abs on the way out. We'll see how we go. Sorry mate, didn't mean to startle you, but I am coming down there. Hey buddy. Hey. Hey buddy. Hello. Oi. this guy's not so sure of me. I came to take out a photo and he turned around and came towards me. He's a bull. Hey, back up. We'll leave him alone. He's probably weighs about the same as me. I think I can go faster than you on the rocks, but I don't really want to fall over. He's a big fella. Let's back up a bit. Hey, you're not intimidated, are you? I'm surprised. I thought you'd bolt for it. Alright, alright. I'll leave you alone. I don't want to act like a coward now. But I won't annoy you anymore. King's got to defend his territory. He's going after his female. He's like, don't you run away from me, miss. It's his lady legging it down there. All right, we'll leave him alone. And we'll go that way and go fishing. So, might need to time that drag a bit. I'm throwing this, again, red tank, Raid 120. Is it a red tank? Or maybe red tank reload. I can't remember. Anyway, red tank lure, stick bait, sinking stick bait. Hooked up a lot of kings on this and just keep either pulling hooks or getting smoked. So we're gonna make it happen this time. That's what I'm going for. Hey, there's a lot of fun on the light gear as well, so let's give it a shot. Look at this. This is a seal turd and look at what is in it. Can you guys see that? That is cuttlefish beaks. Lots of cuttlefish beaks. So I'll tell you what they're eating. Cuttlefish. That's what they love. They're not squid, these are definitely cuttlefish. So that's probably their main diet, is cuttlefish, I'd say. Love a bit of cephalopod. I do too, I'll tell you what. It's very tasty. What's this fella doing? Hey mate, what are you up to? Don't stuff around with any of my gear, please. Fish on the bottom there, seems to be. It's in low. I'll throw a plastic soon if I don't get something. Come on, fish. You're like, whatever's hitting it, it's just in close. I can't see king. So I'll just try to sink it right there. Yep. Oh. Yep, that's a fish. That's a kingie, I reckon. I'm gonna hit it before. That's a good fish. I'd say it's a king. Yeah. This is my dinner if I can land him. So pressure's on. Yes. Gee. I love catching thingies. Oh man, they just never give up. Don't reef me, mate. The dirty fighters. I'm not sure what the structure's like down there. good size. I don't know how well hooked he is. Can we drag him up? Yes! He's a good sized king. On the red tank. And you could do it on PE3. Stoked. Oh, stop it, fish. Oh. Drag him up. Probably give him a quick brain spike to stop him. There we go. We got dinner. Dinner is sorted. So I wanted to do ceviche. So, and this was the prime target for ceviche. And I got it on the red tank on PE3, so I'm stoked. Tippy might be pushing a meter. I make fish look small, unfortunately. I'm just going to quickly measure him. I wouldn't mind knowing what he went. So that's PE3 or 30 pound Tasline. I reckon he's a meter. Let's see what we got. Nah, he isn't. I'm getting excited. He's only 96. Anyway, he's close. I thought he might have cracked a meter. I'm just going to bleed him out now and put him somewhere nice and cool. I'll just try and lay him down. Out of my way, mate. I need to check that my dinner's there. Yeah, good.
Crabs are having a field day.
I'll get him out while I can. Literally a big wave came and washed all around there. I was scared that my dinner had just washed away. So I'll grab it now. We'll lay it up here. While we pack down, because it would really suck to lose him right now. Crabs were loving him. So session is done. It is getting on in the arvo, probably 4:30. So we're going to just pack up and hike back up to camp and get dinner ready. And like I said before, kingfish ceviche is what we are having. I don't think I've had kingfish ceviche yet. I had harlequin ceviche on another trip when I planned on having kingfish ceviche, but we couldn't get one. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. We'll pack down all this stuff and hike up to camp, and we will see you there in a second. All right, we just got back to camp. Just gonna have a quick drink of water and then we're gonna go fill up that kingfish. I would have done it back at the cove, but sometimes you got to do what you got to do to get a good thumbnail shot. Get those YouTube tips. Thumbnail is important. So we'll carry him. I think there'll be a little rock pool down there that we can probably rinse him in, because we had a 7 meter swell yesterday, so it will be fresh. I have no doubt about that. So yeah, we'll head down there. Probably take this down there. Take that with me. Knife in there. And do I need anything else? I think that's it. That's it. All right, cool. Got what we need. We'll head down there. The wild looking ocean. Here comes the spray. This will do it. We'll fill it here. Kingfish ceviche is what we have. And a bit of sashimi. There was olive oil in there. But it does not hold liquids, I've just discovered. So these are all oily, greasy. Don't run away too far. Just fill it off. Very nice fillet. Look at that. Beautiful. Delicious. Give that one a bit of a rinse, got a bit of blood on it. So there's a bit of a rock pool just behind me. Unfortunately, it has a bit of sand in it too. It's got really good high fat content in it. So that there will be burley. Got my chopping board. I want good chunk of that top bit. Chopping board's just not big enough. Let's just cut through that. That's what I want. I need another bag now. Burger it is. There's a wild ocean out there today. But it should be getting better. And go to the seagulls or the ocean. Just cut off these red bits and remove that bone that I just found. So I'll keep cutting up 1 centimeter size cubes until I'm happy, and then we'll make the marinade. The marinade, there was meant to be olive oil in here, probably a good tablespoon or two, but it leaked out of the seal, unfortunately, all over everything. So now we just have some lemons with a lot of seeds, unfortunately. So I meant to put a bit of salt in. So we've got a little bit of salt here. Hopefully that's all right. And I've boiled some quinoa. I don't think you're meant to put quinoa in with ceviche, but I'm going to throw it in just to add a bit of carbs, a bit of extra base for me, so it's a proper meal. I'll put my sashimi in there. I want to get these chips out. So we will just try and drain that into there. Slowly. Not working so well. Traditionally, it will have some sort of onion or spring onion or something in there. So I've got a little bit of red onion. All right. I'm gonna let that do its thing. I'll flood on the outside of the bag. Hopefully that can really marinate away in there. For probably about 1 hour, I'm gonna give it. And I've got bloody an avocado, way more tomatoes than I need. Got freaking tomatoes just rolled on the kingy food. Give them a rinse. So we've got tomatoes, coriander and watercress. threw in. Normally coriander goes in there. I'm just kind of, I don't know if it's meant to go in before or now, whatever. I'm going to get told off for doing it wrong probably, but I'm sure it would taste good. Alright, throw that in there. Might have brought a fork. I don't know. Anyway, you're not going to get restaurant qualities on the rocks from me, unfortunately. But what I really want right now is some sashimi. Use it all up, I might want to have some more later. A little bit of lemon juice and a bit of soy sauce. Throw that away, chuck that in there. Get that everywhere. Make quite the mess here. That can go in there. In there. I'm going to have that up at camp soon. Probably devour that orange soon. What else have we got? I don't know. We got all sorts of crap in there. I didn't want to have some sashimi right now. I'm starving. Let me at it. Need some sashimi. Birds have coming in for dinner. Probably not that much. That is so good. All right, excuse me while I devour all of this, and we have a lot of visitors hanging around hoping to get some. See you guys back up there at camp for dinner shortly. All right, I'm hungry, I'm not waiting any longer. So traditionally you marinate the fish like it's all covered. I didn't have enough lemons. Probably don't. If you want to make ceviche at home, or full stop, check out a recipe rather than following mine. I've only given it about half an hour. Probably an hour would be a bit better. It's starting to get white on the outside, but you want the white to probably be a bit further in. It depends on how pickled you want it to be. Essentially, we're eating dinner. I'm hungry. Been waiting for this for too long. There we go. So there you go, kingfish ceviche. It's really nice. Okay, it was good. All right, I'm gonna sit back and enjoy my dinner in my lovely ice cream container that I brought out. And enjoy the sunset. Tomorrow morning, I'm getting up early. We're doing a trek down the other end. We is me on my own. Don't know why I say we sometimes, but anyway. And I'm gonna try find some good ledges down there to fish. See if we can get some bottom fish, maybe some jewfish, some nannies, nanny guy or bite red snapper. Probably be kingies around. Anyway, that's the plan. We'll head down there. We'll see what we can catch. And then I'll be camping back here again tomorrow night. All right, thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you then.